In the production phase, we have to take all the contents from the design phase and translate them into a video game language. In order to do this, the first thing you have to do is to know the software which you are going to use. Once you are familiarized with the software, you already know at least a part of the possibilities that you can use to transform all that content that you prepared in the design phase, the storyboard, the narrative, etc., into something more tangible, like the game mechanics and other game elements. The three parts of this production phase are the graphics, the game elements, and the programming. About the graphics, you have to look for graphic resources on the internet, or you can create them and then import them into the software. And also a very important part of the graphics part is to create the scenarios where the game will take place. About the game elements, you can create many different kinds of game elements, like characters, enemies, items, and other specifics of the game. Normally, software has a database where you can include all these elements, and whenever you have to use them, you can take them from that database and apply them. Finally, the third part is the most important part, is the programming. You already have graphics, you already have game elements, but if you don't program them, they are going to do nothing. You have to tell them how they have to act once a player is touching a key or doing something in the game. The programming part includes almost anything you can do in the game, like opening treasure chests, opening dialogues, making decisions, and anything the player can do in the game.